guys. Hi, friends. So today I have a different type of video for you guys. I have been telling you guys for some time now that I was going to share our story on how we met. It's a funny story, and not a lot of people believe that it's true, but it is true. And I wanted to share this and do this with you guys because on May 31st, we will be celebrating our wedding anniversary. 15 years, right? Is it 15 years? We got married in 31st. 2009. Yeah, and we're in 2023. How many years? Do the math. I forgot. I forgot how many years that would be, you guys. I think it's 4. Is it 14 or 15, Jaden? Huh? Can somebody do the math? I mean, you know, my phone is being used to record. It's 14 years? Okay, 14 years. So, with that being said, I'm going to introduce you guys to my husband. Say hello.
Hi.
This is Alex, the hubby that I'm always talking about that always yells at me about going to the Dollar Tree. Yeah, that's him. That's him right there. Anyway, guys, so let's take it back. We're going to go back into time. It's 1999, right? That's the year we met. Okay, 1999. I was a sophomore, I believe. A freshman, sophomore in high school. What were you in 99? A freshman in college, right? Yeah, because you graduated grammar school at grammar school, high school in 98, right?
Yeah. Sorry.
Why are you laughing?
No, I'm talking to Sub-Zero.
Okay, guys. Mm-hmm. So, yes, he graduated grammar school, high school in 98. So, when we met, he was a freshman in college. So, back then, if you guys are young and do not know, we had beepers, right? Did we have beepers?
Obviously, how you met me.
Well, yeah. So we had beepers. And if you guys remember, or if you don't know what a beeper was, it was a little device that you used to carry around on your waistband.
I think people do know what
some
a beeper
people
is.
Don't, though. Some people don't. And you used to have to use a phone, call the number that you wanted to page, and page the person. Well, I remember I was bored. I was stuck at home. I had nothing to do. And I had a phone book. Yes, guys, back then we used to use little books like this. And it was like an address book. And it used to have phone numbers and all that good stuff. So I had a guy friend, that I had his beeper number. But he had changed his number. And I had the two numbers next to each other. And we were supposed to hang out that day. So I was paging him to ask around what time we were going to hang out. Well, I paged the old number, not knowing. And the next thing I know, now, I used to have a phone in my bedroom, a landline phone in my bedroom. That was my private line. So the next thing I know, I get a phone call back. Well, no, it was a landline, a house phone. Yeah, but my mom had hers and I had mine. You know, remember, hello. So then the next thing I know, somebody calls me back. And it's not my friend. It was him. And what did you say? Look at yourself in the camera right now. What did you say?
Make use of the number?
No. How did the conversation start?
I don't remember.
Hello, someone beeped me from this number?
Well, obviously, that's how you would say.
So I said, I'm sorry, I must have had the wrong number. Who's this? And he said, your name? What's your name?
Alex.
Yeah. And I said, okay, well, I think I paged the wrong number. Something to that effect, not the exact words. I'm not going to remember that. That was, 24 years ago? Yeah, 24 years ago. So I don't remember the exact words, but I said, I think I paged the wrong number. I'm sorry. And then his famous words were,
I make use of the number or not?
Should I delete this number or should I make use of it? Mind you, we didn't know what we looked like. We were just hearing each other's voices for the first time. And I said, do whatever you want. and we hung up. But then the very next day, I think it was it the next day or that same night that you called me back?
Jen, I'm 42. You think I'm gonna remember?
Well, I don't remember if it was that same night, guys, or if it was the next day, but he did call me back and we stayed on the phone for hours. And we were trying to figure out if we had mutual friends because Hudson County is small. Now, I grew up more so in Bergen County because that's where I went to school. I went to an all-girl Catholic high school. Yes, unfortunately. But he went, you know, to public school in Hudson County in Union City. And my grandmother lived in West New York and I lived in North Bergen at the time with my mom. So we were trying to figure out if we had mutual friends. We were throwing names back and forth. I was trying to figure out if I knew his twin sister and all that stuff. So what ended up happening was a few days after we started talking on the phone, he said, well, let's meet up. And I said, okay, why don't you come by my grandmother's house? And I had my brother with me. My brother is 2 years younger than I am. So I told my brother, I was like, listen, this guy is gonna come by. I don't know what he looks like. I don't know anything, you know, really about him physically. I just know that we were talking and we clicked, right? We were like clicking our conversations and stuff.
Yes.
You guess?
Yeah.
So with that being said, I said to my brother, if I look at you a certain way, I go like this, it means like come up with an excuse so that we can leave. If I go like that to you, it means you leave us alone, right? So guys, oh my God, back then, remember?
I don't think your mom knows about that. She's gonna be happy about that.
What, my mom? Well, back then, contacts were in style, right? Everyone used to have contacts. I had green contacts, so I put in my contacts. I remember the outfit and everything I was wearing. I had a skort on. You guys remember the skorts, the shorts, and it had like the flap in the front that looked like a skirt. Those are kind of coming back. I've seen a couple of them in Target lately.
You catfished me with those contacts.
He says I catfished him with the contacts. But yes, so he ends up coming on rollerblades with his best friend, okay, at the time. And he came from downtown. Now, mind you, he was on like, were you on 8th Street that day or were you by Mikey's house?
I don't remember.
Well, if he was by his friend's house, that would have been 40-something street. And I was on 64th. So that was like 20 blocks, guys. And he came on rollerblades to see me with his friend walking with him. So when he gets there, I will never forget, he was wearing a black CK shirt, Calvin Klein shirt with Calvin Klein jeans, and he asked his friend to switch shoes with him because of course he was on rollerblades. I don't know what he was thinking, but he was on rollerblades. So they switched shoes, and I remember just looking at my brother and going like, and he wasn't getting the hint, and I'm like, he still wasn't getting the hint. So I go, okay, let's go for a walk on Park Avenue. Mind you, I'm at my grandmother's house. My uncle was upstairs, super overprotective family, Cuban, so I wasn't allowed to do anything, even though I was already 16 years old, so, you know, I should have been allowed, but anyway. So we went walking on Park Avenue, and I was so scared that someone was going to see me and tell my grandmother or my grandfather or my uncle that I was out there with, like, some random guy holding hands in the street. So we went walking, and I remember being super nervous. And guys, literally from that day on, we started seeing each other every single day. Every day he would come from 8th Street to 64th Street to see me, or vice versa. When I introduced him to my mom, like, my mom was always super cool. My mom, you know, tried to be as laid back as she possibly could. So she always allowed him to come over the house, and, you know, we were good kids. We were hanging out. We would watch TV in my room. I remember we always had to have the door open and all that stuff. And then when I introduced him to my dad's side of the family, because my grandmother and my grandfather is houses where I met him, and my brother and I were always there every weekend, he was super nervous. There was a barbecue at my aunt's house in Bergenfield, and my mom drove us there and dropped us off. And I remember my best friend was here from Pennsylvania, so she came along as well. And my aunt, as a prank, told my grandmother that he was Dominican. Now, here's the thing. There's nothing wrong with Dominicans. My grandson is half Dominican, but my grandmother at the time was, for some reason, somewhat racist towards Dominicans. She didn't like them. And she just had something against them, and she did not want anyone in her family with a Dominican man. I don't know why, but that's the way she was at the time. So as a joke, my aunt pranked me, told my grandmother, and my grandmother kept giving him like a dirty look until finally we said, no, he's half Cuban, half Costa Rican. And then my grandmother was fine. And I remember like my grandfather would drive from his house on 64th Street all the way to 8th Street to pick him up and drop him off sometimes. And we would go to like all these Goya parties and parties for La Fe, because my grandfather was into all that distributing and stuff. He had a distributing company, so he knew a lot of people in high places, and we were always invited to all of these parties, and he would come with me. So I was finally allowed to like have a boyfriend. He was the first boyfriend that I ever introduced to my family, and the only one. I mean, we got married, right? So it was crazy, guys. From that day forward, we have been together. We've had our ups and downs. We had our oldest daughter when I was 17 going on 18. You were 20, right? 20 going on 21. Yeah. You were already 21 because she was born in October. So we had Destiny October 7th of 2001. Then we had Brianna December 5th. Of 2002, so they're only 14 months apart. We waited 10 years to get married because I wanted to be sure that we were, if we got married, that was it. No divorce. No divorce, no nothing.
I was like, what the hell are you guys waiting for?
Yeah, seriously, we already lived together and everything, so everyone was like, what are you guys waiting for? But I really wanted to make sure, guys, because to me, I always wanted to have a sweet 15s, a quinceañera, or a sweet 16s, and I never got to have one because my dad wasn't around for other reasons. Then my grandfather got very ill when I was turning 16. He had cancer and unfortunately passed away that year that I turned 16, literally in March, my birthday month. So we were not able to celebrate my quinceañera or my sweet 16s. So to me, my wedding was going to be all of that and more, right? So I wanted a big lavish wedding, which I will tell you guys now, I so regret it because we spent so much money on that wedding and we did enjoy ourselves and we had a great time, but we could have used that money to put a down payment on a house. I highly, highly recommend people that have not gotten married, guys, do something small for you. Because at the end of the day, you're paying for other people to come to your wedding to enjoy your money. And half the people that are there, let's be real, are talking crap about you. I mean, it's reality, right? People talk. So with that being said, we enjoyed our wedding. We loved it, but our honeymoon was like the best. It was the first time that we were leaving the country together. And we went to Aruba for 10 days, right? It was 10 days.
I remember.
And we had such a good time. He's usually really talkative. He's just being shy right now, just an FYI. But yes, so we had such a great time, but we missed our girls like crazy. So when we returned from the trip, I remember telling him, okay, if we're going to have a third kid, it's either now or never, because I wanted to go back to college and get my degree. And I knew that he wanted a son because we had two girls. So we tried for the boy and we ended up with Jaden. So Jaden was born literally a year after our wedding. We got married in 2009, May 31st of 2009. Jaden was born October 6th of 2010. So Jaden and Destiny's birthdays are back to back, except for the years are switched. She's 01 and he's 2010. So yeah, guys, we had Jaden. I said, that's it, no more babies. I got my tubes tied. I did not want any more kids. And our family was definitely complete then. I went back to school. I got my degree in criminal justice. Finally, it was long overdue, but I only ended up with my associate's degree. I always wanted to go back for my bachelor's, but I'll be honest, guys, I don't think I have the patience today to go to school, work, be a wife, be a mom, you know, maintain a household. There's no way. I definitely do not have, and it's too expensive. Let's not even talk about the patience. The expense is just insane. So yeah, guys, we have been together for 24 years. August 12th of 1999. Mm-hmm. We literally, the funny part is that we celebrate that day more than we do our wedding anniversary. Like, our dating anniversary is more of the day that we usually go more out for. Like, you know, we'll go to the Poconos for the weekend, or we'll just go out to dinner. We'll go, oh my God, Sojo. We have to go to Sojo. So we have a little place nearby. It's a spa, and they have all of these different aquatic pools, and they're all for like different things, and we love going there. So every now and then we'll go there. But one thing that I will say is, and we've learned this the hard way, guys, one thing that helps your relationship and your marriage work throughout the years is that you always have to continue to date your spouse. You always have to play.
So you're not gonna date anybody else.
You always have to come up with like a date night. Even if it's once a month, I would like it to be once a week or once every 2 weeks. But he works crazy hours and I understand that. And sometimes he's not here on the weekends because he's working. So we're working on that. But definitely always date your spouse, go out, be spontaneous. You don't have to spend a lot of money. And that's something I always tell him. A date night does not have to be a $200 dinner. A date night can simply be walking down the block on Boulevard East by where we live, looking at the New York skyline and just spending time together. That's it. I would even consider a date night making a nice dinner and eating it on the balcony and then walking and going for some ice cream or something. Like something like that, where it's just you and your significant other. And I that's something that my aunt and my uncle have always told me, and they used to tell you too when you used to work over there, right? One thing that's always helped their marriage is to always plan a date night, date each other. So with that being said, I hope you guys found this video cute, funny, informative. Now you know a little bit more about us and our life. And if you can smile and not look so miserable, like, am I choking you making? I have a knife here, guys, and I'm making him do this. But yeah, guys, I just wanted to share our story with you guys. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Hit the like button. Hit that bell so that you get notified each and every time I upload a new video. I love you guys. I hope you guys are staying safe out there. Bye, amigas, and I will see you guys again soon. Bye, guys.